I'm a fire guy. I've been passionate about fire for a long time. As a matter of fact, it was my first birthday, and I had a cake. And there was one candle there, and the candle was lighted, and it was a flame. So I stuck my finger in the candle, in the flame, and was fascinated by it to the point where I didn't remove my finger. I just started to cry, but I would not remove my finger from that light. And I've been chasing fire ever since. So fast forward 60 years, and here we are, BC 2017. Come with me. It's July 14th. It's Friday afternoon, 4:45. The temperature is about 36, 37 Celsius. RH is 10, 11, 12%. Winds are gusting 45. Ashcroft is in the foreground, and the fire called Elephant Hill is in the background. We were there for about 5 hours, and we went up on the left-hand side, and I'm not sure if this has a laser pointer. Anyway, flames were going up 100 meters. It was just crazy. And within the 5 hours we were there, that smoke was already into Jasper National Park. It was just a moving. So I'm afraid here, okay. So I took this picture off my computer Sunday, a gorgeous day Sunday, we were having some gorgeous weather, big upper ridge. This is taken from a satellite about 37,000 kilometers above their surface, and it rotates at the same speed as the Earth, so it always sits over the same spot and just takes picture after picture after picture, called GOES, geostationary satellite. And I took this to remind me we have one planet, and we're doing an unplanned experiment. There is no plan B here. We cannot go to the moon. We cannot go to Mars. We have to take care of this planet. There was the UN IPCC report, special report out recently, saying we're seeing much more severe consequences from climate change than expected, given just a small amount of warming thus far. And this is particularly true with fire. We are seeing a lot more fire. And there we go again. So here's a map showing fire across Canada. So this is an Alberta problem. It's not a BC problem, though we'll see a lot more red. This only goes to 2017, 2018, another record year in British Columbia. It's a problem from sea to sea to sea. In fact, it's a global problem. There was fires in Portugal last year, deadly. California fires last year, this year. Greece this year. So fire is definitely in the news. So you need three ingredients for fire. Fuel and the boreal forest. Lots of fuel, ignition, lightning and people, and weather. Hot, dry, windy weather like we saw in that first slide. And with climate change, we expect more extreme weather, more hot, dry, windy weather, which dries the fuels, which means it's easier for fires to start, spread, and burn more intensely. And this bottom picture here is actually a fire burning in November in the Northwest Territories. It's burning in peat, organic material, and it smolders right through winter, right into the next year. So this shows global monthly temperature on Earth. And since December 1984, we've been above normal. Over 400 months, I see a trend here, and it's not a good trend. We are getting much warmer. And out of comparison, I gave my first talk on climate change in the fall of 1985, and we were already on that roller coaster ride to much warmer conditions. So the warmer we get, the more fire we see. I get asked this question all the time, why is temperature so important? Well, because the warmer we get, the longer the fire season. Our fire season in Alberta now starts March 1st. It used to be April 1st. And in 2016 and 2017, we had fires in February. Not in 2018, we had a cold spring this year. The warmer it gets, the more lightning we see. More lightning, the more fires we'll get. The warmer it is, the drier the fuels, because the temperature is very effective. Warmer temperatures are sucking moisture out of the fuel. Drier fuels, easier for fires to start and spread, burn more intensely. High-intensity fires are very difficult to put out. And so we're left with some options here. Mother Nature, there's a picture from Fort McMurray just above waterways, which I took in May of 2016. Then one of my students took a picture on the right in the fall, and you can see Mother Nature is regenerating. And then, but if we get past the threshold or tipping point, regeneration might not be possible, and the forest would disappear as we know it today. So, you know, this is what may be in store for us. Now, this last slide was taken on that August day. Some of you may remember, you got up, it started to get bright, and then it got darker again because of smoke. So even though fire may not affect downtown Edmonton, though the river valley may be at risk in places, the smoke from fires does, as we saw this last August. And it got darker and the streetlights came on. This is close to where I live, and there's Saskatchewan Drive. Looking across the city, if you've got very good eyes, you can see the streetlights are on, and this is about 9 o'clock in the morning. And you can just see the outline of buildings across the river valley. This really bad visibility. But I'm going from personal or from professional to personal. I walk to work every day. So we've moved back to Edmonton. This is our third time. And I said, I want to be able to walk to work or walk to the LRT to get to work. So I see one way forward is walking, okay? And reducing car use, having walkable neighborhoods like we do around Strathcona. We should have more of them, okay? Thank you for your time.